periodontal infections, attributes to preterm birth, which will be taken forward by Dr. K. Srinivas, who is currently a consultant oral physician and dental surgeon at Manipal Hospital, Bangalore. And he's also one of the first persons to start exclusive oral medicine clinic in Karnataka at Manipal Hospital in 2003. And his special interests are oral manifestation of systemic diseases, dental management of medically compromised, practice of oral medicine, facial pain, dry mouth and saliva dysfunctions. Please, sir.
A very warm good morning to one and all present here. Well, today I'm going to talk something about dental periodontal infections and attributes to preterm birth. So I would basically be concentrating, first we'll see what exactly is periodontitis, and then what has oral cavity to do with pregnancy, what are the physiological changes that you see in the oral cavity during pregnancy, and what is the link between periodontitis and preterm low birth weight babies. Now we all see this, we have a healthy set of gums and teeth, but I would want you to recognize what exactly is the periodontium. If you look at the anatomy of the tooth, we see that the tooth is encased inside the bone here. Tooth is encased inside the bone, and like how we have ligaments getting attached between bone to bone, the tooth is also attached to the bone with the help of a periodontal membrane. So what we see outside is only the coronal part of the tooth and the gums. Inside lies the bone, the periodontal membrane. Now all these three put together, the gums, the bone and the periodontal membrane, constitute the periodontium. Inflammation of this periodontium is called periodontitis. In this disease, the tooth is sound. There is no decay. There is no problem with the teeth. But there is inflammation of the surrounding structures or the supporting structures of the tooth, that is called as periodontitis. This is essentially a bacterial infection predominated by gram-negative anaerobes. Now the source of this infection, the bacteria, comes from a dental biofilm. Most of us know about dental plaque, but the dental plaque is invisible to the naked eye. To make the dental plaque visible, we need to apply vegetable dyes, and when we apply this disclosing solution, we can see the dental plaque. This dental plaque is a biofilm which is composed of thousands of bacterial colonies that is housed in almost all the individuals on the earth. Now, periodical cleaning is suggested for all the patients, which we don't do. Now, if we leave it at this stage, the amount of plaque accumulation increases and we see something like this. Now, gradually what happens, this particular plaque will start imbibing the minerals from the saliva and it solidifies and it becomes tartar. This is what we see in our advertisements, in our television. Most of the people confuse this for plaque. This is not plaque, this is tartar, known as calculus. Now these two things put together, the plaque and the calculus, are called as local factors which house colonies of bacteria that cause periodontal inflammation and periodontitis, or the periodontal disease. Now in periodontal disease, what basically happens is, initially there is inflammation of the gums, and then the attachment between the gums and the teeth is destroyed, which deepens the sulcus of the gums. Then slowly it will destroy the bone. When the supporting bone gets lost, the tooth will start getting mobile. Now here you can see that the prevalence of periodontitis in India varies from 46% to 78%. And what happens here is, initially you can see redness of gums. Slowly there is a destruction of the gums, receding of gums. You can see the deposits there. And then you will start seeing that the teeth are becoming mobile, and gradually there is spacing in between the teeth. And in severe periodontitis, the teeth will start moving apart and you will see mobility of the teeth. This is periodontitis. Now, during pregnancy, there are a lot of physiological changes that we see inside the mouth. Now, there are two conditions that are important for us to understand the physiological changes in the mouth. Most important is the pregnancy gingivitis. The prevalence of pregnancy gingivitis is about 30 to 100%. Now, I showed you the dental plaque. What happens in pregnancy is, there is an exaggerated response of dental plaque by the host tissues. Now, there are two reasons for that. One is the bacterial factor and one is the host factor. Now let us first see what exactly is the host factor. Now you all are aware of the fact that there is a rise in the hormone level from the 2nd to 8th month of pregnancy. This also coincides with the gingivitis. After the 8th month, the pregnancy gingivitis also tends to come down. Now, what is the action of progesterone in the mouth? The gingival capillaries get dilated and there is increased permeability of the gingival capillaries and it increases the exudate formation. This is the action of progesterone on the gums. And the estrogen causes changes in the keratinization of gums and it alters the ground substance of the gums and it impairs wound healing. This is how the host inflammatory response is changed in during pregnancy. Now because of these two factors, there is a more florid response to the irritant effects of dental plaque on the mouth. That is why pregnancy gingivitis results. The second and the other interesting fact is, there is a peculiar organism that that causes gingivitis in pregnancy that is called Prevotella intermedia. Now this Prevotella intermedia, it feeds on this estrogen and progesterone because chemically and structurally these hormones can substitute for naphthoquinone, which is a growth factor essentially for Prevotella intermedia. Therefore during pregnancy, what has been demonstrated that there is a 5- to 6-fold increase in this particular organism inside the mouth that can cause gingivitis. Now the second condition in pregnancy, now what happens in pregnancy gingivitis is, it is little peculiar than the other forms of gingivitis. The anterior aspect of the mouth is more affected and the gums in between the teeth, the interdental papilla you can see here, are red and enlarged. The second condition is a pregnancy tumor. A tumor is a misnomer here. It is just a reactive lesion. It is a reactive lesion in response to the accentuated inflammation that is present during pregnancy in the mouth. The frequency is about 2 to 9.6%. There is again an additive effect of progesterone and methyl hydroxyprogesterone, which causes an inhibition in collagenase production and promotes reactive lesion formation. It's not a serious issue, just a simple excision can take care of this particular disease. Now let's talk about the periodontal. Now that you know what exactly is periodontitis, it's easy for me to make you aware what exactly is the link between these two things. Lot of studies have been done on preterm and low birth weight infants and they have postulated lot of factors that can link these two things, but with regards to preeclampsia, it is only by epidemiological studies they have been established that there is a link between these two, but scientifically they have not proven any link between periodontal disease and preeclampsia. The first evidence of this particular thing came into light when Collins in 1994 injected a periodontal pathogen called Porphyromonas gingivalis into pregnant hamsters. After injecting this, he could demonstrate there was intrauterine growth retardation, and in response to this P. gingivalis, he could show there is an increase in interleukin-1 beta and PGE2 in the amniotic fluid. After this, the dental fraternity started thinking alternatively and they started doing studies. In 1996, Offenbacher did a case control study and he established a strong relationship between periodontitis with an odds of 7.9 between preterm birth babies and low birth weight babies. From 1996 till date, they have done about 464 studies given in the English literature with one Cochrane review. A positive association was found in 60% of studies. Now many epidemiological studies have found a positive association, but there are conflicting results because there was a problem with classification of periodontitis in these diseases and there was a bias with regards to the methodology and it has been not done in various populations. That is why there are conflicting results. Whatever may be the case, what I would like to say is this: there are about 23 systematic reviews that are found showing a strong evidence for an association between periodontal disease and adverse pregnancy outcomes. Say about 40% of studies have shown that there is no significant relationship between these two. After this, the dental fraternity went ahead and saw, by doing periodontal treatment during pregnancy, is there a change in the adverse pregnancy outcomes? So there are about 50 to 60 studies done in between 2000 and 2017. What they have shown is the impact of periodontal treatment on preterm birth and adverse pregnancy outcome is unclear. That means there is a low quality evidence. Most of this is associated with bias. Now, what exactly causes this? Sir Dr. Chandrasekhar explained, there is a transitory bacteremia in the mouth, and what they have postulated is through hematogenous spread, these periodontal pathogens travel to the placenta and they induce labor. And oral cavity also acts as a microbial niche, acts as a reservoir wherein the bacteria can spread through the hematogenous route and reach the placenta. The other thing that has come into light is there is one ubiquitous organism called Fusobacterium nucleatum, which is more prevalent in mothers with periodontal disease as well as mothers who gave birth to preterm low birth weight babies. They have taken vaginal smears and they have done PCRs also to prove that this organism is coexistent in the oral cavity as well as the fetal cavity. The other hypothesis is that there is a direct transmission of the microorganisms from mouth to the vaginal cavity through sexual practices. Now, the other supporting things regarding this association is there are two keystone microorganisms, the Porphyromonas gingivalis and Filifactor alkosis causing periodontitis. They have seen regularly that these two organisms are present in the mouth as well as the amniotic fluid of preterm low birth weight mothers. And not only this, the other organisms that cause periodontal inflammation has been detected in the cord blood samples of preterm and full-term birth babies in longitudinal studies. Now, the second thing that I would like to emphasize is it has been postulated that when these bacteria translocate to the fetoplacental sac, the endotoxin lipopolysaccharide is released, which is sensed by the toll-like receptors which are present on almost all immune cells that lead to the production of prostanoids. I think the previous speaker has explained what is the effect. So I am just linking that to the dental pathogens. Now, finally, induction of labor and preterm birth. This is the hypothesis explained, like how exactly periodontitis is causing the preterm birth. Now, the indirect pathway is, as sir told, there are a lot of pro-inflammatory cytokines released in the mouth as a result of periodontal infection. Now, these pro-inflammatory cytokines, they travel through the bloodstream and reach the placenta. The four important cytokines, these are all based on the longitudinal studies that I have picked up from. Either they reach the placenta via the bloodstream, or the gingival pro-inflammatory cytokines reach the liver and promote production of acute phase proteins like, for example, C-reactive protein, what sir told, which act on the fetal placental unit and induce labor. Now, this is the, I've given the summary of the studies so far being done that can cause preterm birth because of periodontitis. Finally, what I would like to say is poor periodontal health in pregnant women is definitely a risk factor for adverse pregnancy outcomes, and it needs to be informed to the patient that definitely it is a risk factor. And I feel oral health status should become a column regularly in the obstetrician's case record, and all gynecologists should at least do a simple examination. They should try and identify whether there is any tartar, bleeding gums, swollen gums. It's very, very simple. Now, periodontal treatment during pregnancy has definitely an impact on preterm birth, even though there is a low quality of evidence. So finally, I would like to recommend dental screening and treatment should be advised at the preconception stage itself, because some people feel that doing periodontal treatment is better only in the second trimester of pregnancy. Most of the patients now, they come to you people at a preconception stage. Please tell them to go to a dentist and get a preventive treatment done, the screening done, etc., so on and so forth. So preventive oral care services should be provided as early in pregnancy as possible. And whatever is the stage of periodontitis, we don't do any surgical treatment during that. What we do is only non-surgical treatment. And if examination indicates a need for treatment, it is usually scheduled in early in second trimester. And the treatment that we do here is very, very simple. We don't do any surgical treatment during pregnancy or even for a normal individual in the initial stages. What I have shown you initially, the local factors, the plaque and the calculus, we either use hand instruments or ultrasonic instruments, and we try to remove the plaque as well as calculus. That is the only thing that we do. In dental terminologies, it is called oral prophylaxis or the dental professional cleaning. Only in certain situations where the tartar extends beyond the gum, we do a procedure called root planing. Again, it is removal of these local factors from the root surfaces of the teeth. That's all we do. And thank you for your patient listening.